Welcome to Dissecting Mexican Slang, where we explain Mexican slang words and idioms. My name is Dulce and I will be your host. Today, we're going to review, again, the word cabrón, but this time as an adjective. Cabrón as an adjective is different than the other ways in which we use the word, because depending on the situation, cabrón can be offensive in this case. We use cabrón as an adjective to describe a person, an object, or a situation. And it doesn't mean the same thing all the time. For example, when describing a person, cabrón can be a good thing or it can be a bad thing, depending on the context. But when describing a situation or an object, it works as an amplifier. We use it to denote intensity or level of difficulty. There are several situations in which we call cabrón to someone, and that means a bad thing. Let's start describing. To begin with, we call cabrón to someone who likes to perform pranks on other people. Someone who can't stay quiet, not even for a little while. Someone who's hyper and it's always doing bad things. Basically, someone naughty. We usually use this on kids because they're very hyper and they're always doing this and that. So we usually use it with kids, but adults are not exempt. An example for kids could be, for example, when they're pulling someone else's hair or biting other kids. So you could easily say that that kid is a cabrón. And in adults, well, it's just when they're naughty. Okay, and so another description for cabrón. That's a bad thing, I'm sorry, a mosquito. It's when someone is mean. Someone who does bad things to people, no matter who they are, sometimes even their families. Someone whose attitude affects other people. So basically, it's kind of like a douchebag. And now we have another situation that is also bad when we call people cabrón. And that is when you're a cheater. That means when you're cheating on someone, then you say that you andas de cabrón. So here we say andar de cabrón, or he anda de cabrón, she anda de cabrona. And that means that you are cheating on your partner, or you're dating multiple guys or multiple girls. We also call people cabrón to their faces when we're angry, or when we're disappointed, maybe they did something bad. And so we say something like, ¿qué cabrón eres? Ya ni la chingas. And when we say that, that means that we are telling them basically that they're mean and that we are angry and or disappointed. But now let's go to the good things. We have one situation in which we can call someone a cabrón, and that means a good thing. We call someone cabrón as a good thing when someone is really, really good at something, or maybe an expert in something. And that something can basically be anything. For example, Luis is bien cabrón para las matemáticas. That means that Luis is really, really good at math. But you can also say, puedo conseguir a todas las chicas que yo quiera. Soy bien cabrón. And that means I can get all the girls I want. I'm very good at it. And now to describe objects and situations. To describe objects and situations, we use it, as I said, to denote intensity, the level of difficulty, or maybe the amount. For example, in a really hard situation, you can say, estuvo bien cabrón, which means the situation was really intense or was really difficult. You can also say, for example, el examen estuvo bien cabrón, which means the exam was very difficult. And now when you have a lot of something or something is really intense, you can say la gripa te agarró bien cabrón, which means you got a very intense flu. Or, for example, you can say, ah, me pica bien cabrón, which means it itches a lot. Or when you go out, you can say, El sol está bien cabrón, which means the sun is really intense. And so as you can see, there are many ways in which we can use cabrón. Some of them are good, some of them are bad. Some others are not really good at bad or bad. It just means, I don't know, that you have a lot of something. Something's really intense. Something's really hard. So, oh my god. So, yes, that was it for today. I hope this was helpful for you. And if you have any comments, questions, requests, doubts, anything, you can just leave them in the comments below. And I will get back to you. So, see you next time. Bye.